Hey, in San Jose, is it hockey? No. Playoff hockey starts us off. And how are the Sharks going to respond tonight? Now, the Sharks, hey, they still have that 2-1 series lead over the LA Kings. It's game four tonight of the first round of the playoffs. But is there any kind of lingering uh-oh moment after that overtime loss Monday night?
You know, you're dealing with a team that's won 2 Stanley Cups in the last 4 or 5 years, so they're not going to go away quietly. We knew this wasn't going to be easy.
Coach DeBoer speaking. Here's that Tanner overtime goal off a Sharks turnover. That was the difference in what has been a tough physical matchup. We all expected that. Coach was asked about the Kings out hitting the Sharks by 22. Certainly more aggressive. They killed all 5 of the Sharks' power plays.
They turned the tables a little bit on us there. I think we were on the other end of those. Those are the little battles within a series. And, you know, I think it definitely is an indicator of where your game's at and your desperation level's at. So, you know, that tells me, you know, theirs was in a must-win spot, and ours was a little bit below that. So we've got to get it back there.
NBA playoff talk now, and the Warriors, where the question isn't whether or not they're going to beat the Houston Rockets. It's, will Steph Curry play?
Based on how I feel right now, I probably couldn't play. But tomorrow, it could be different.
Yeah, Curry not sounding positive about his chances of playing in Game 3 tomorrow night in Houston. But the good news is that he did practice today. And the quicker he returns, the better for Dr. Kerr.
So he's doing a lot better. And I'm not going to talk about whether it was his foot or his ankle, because I obviously messed that one up. It's tough when you're a basketball coach being asked medical questions.
Do you know if it's a high ankle sprain?
I don't even know what a high ankle sprain is.
Oh,
nor do I know what a sports hernia is.
Okay.
And flu-like symptoms. Is that like the flu, or is it just kind of like the flu?
Now, as for the Rockets, what can you say? Blown out in Game 1, gave up 115 points without Curry in Game 2. But at least one Rocket is hopeful things will be different in Houston.
Our key defensively is, again, to bring a physical presence on both ends of the floor, regardless of who's in those uniforms. Chris Mullin, Tim Hardaway, and Rich Richmond could come out in those Warrior uniforms, and we still got to play the same way.
Hey, golf, Lydia Ko got wet after winning her second major title earlier this month. Back in Daly City with the LPGA as the swinging skirts defending champion. She's the only champion this event has ever known. Trying to win back to back to back. And I asked her about this Lake Merced course being such a comfort zone.
It's really cool to, you know that you've played well at this tournament before and you've got confidence going into this week. But you know, with that, there's, I think, a little bit more added pressure because you are the defending champion and they know that you've won here before, so why can't you do it again?
And if memory serves, if you win it this time, you'd be doing it on your 19th birthday. Am I correct?
Yes. Wow. Yeah. Wow. So either way, it'll be a fun Sunday.
You know, I'm looking at this tat here on your wrist. Is this the date of your first win?
Yeah, you know, it's a date that I'm proud of. Yeah. April 27, 2014. So, you know, I might forget my birthday, you know, later when I'm older, but I'll probably remember this one.
Hey, first round tomorrow. Hey, a couple of baseball notes for you. The A's do lead the Yankees 5-2 in the ninth. Highlights of that coming up on the late show with the Giants and the Diamondbacks. But at hand, here in San Jose, it's all about the San Jose Sharks trying to get over on the Kings, trying to get a 3-1 advantage in this playoff. I got my best man, Joe Cousins, behind the camera, working on that post game for us later on tonight.
Awesome.
Back to you in studio.
Time to quit talking and start skating. All right, Vern Glenn, thanks, Vern.
Thanks, Vern.